we've got here our Outer Worlds game that was supposed to be all about campfires and exploration will be delayed to 2019. Outer Worlds is a sci-fi exploration game that is developed by Mobius Digital in partnership with Annapurna Interactive. The game was previously announced to be arriving later this year, but with only a few more days before the year ends, the developer made the announcement that the game will be delayed sometime next year. They are not working hard to launch a polished and stable version of the game. And let's head into our next update. We've got here Agony spin-off Succubus heading to Steam. Well, a more action-oriented spin-off called Succubus is in the works from Agony developers Mad Mind Studio, and the game will star the same Succubus in Agony who became the new queen of hell and is now out for revenge on the powerful demon Baphomet. The trailer shows the same brutal and gory aesthetics Agony was known for, but this time there's a heavy focus on hand-to-hand combat. Players will also have access to weapons, armor, and pyrokinetic powers, complete with an expandable skill tree. And let's have here For Honor gets four new heroes. Well, Ubisoft has revealed that For Honor's Year 3 pass, called the Year of the Harbinger, will be bringing four new heroes. The first is a new knight hero called the Vortiger, who arrives on January 31st, and players will be able to purchase the new hero for 15,000 steel. Year 3 Season 2 will then see the addition of a new samurai hero, followed by a new Viking hero in Season 3, and then a new woolen hero in Season 4. The Year 3 Pass is available for purchase now and includes an elite outfit for all upcoming new heroes. Well, up next, a new PvP mode for Fallout 76 announced. And Bethesda has revealed that they are working on a new PvP mode for Fallout 76 that they will be implementing in early next year. Well, the current PvP system has been heavily criticized as it left the initiator at a great disadvantage and it didn't really feel rewarding enough for players to deem it necessary to participate. It will be interesting to see what kind of new system the devs come up with, and they also promised a fix for the infamous bug that led to a robot duplicating themselves at Wide Spring. Well, up next, we've got here Sandbox RPG Outward out next year. Well, Deep Silver and Nine Dots have announced the release date for their upcoming open-world RPG Outward, and the game is now set to be released on March 26, 2019, and will be available for players in PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One. The game boasts of setting itself apart from other RPGs with its deep survival mechanics. It also features a local multiplayer option, which allows players to play with another player using the same system, while both can also interact with other players all over the globe. And so we've got here Hitman 2 hits over 350,000 concurrent players with free Christmas level. And Hitman 2 brought back Hitman 1's holiday hoarders contract for this year's Christmas season, and it seems that it was a big hit among fans. The game has hit a new pack player count of 356,867, and maybe just the special mission that brought in all those players. That number is the sixth highest in Steam history, overtaking Monster Hunter World's current peak. In case you haven't played through the mission yet, you've got plenty of time left to complete it, as it runs until January 8th. Up next, we've got Black Desert Online pre-orders for Xbox One announced. And the Pearl Abyss has announced that pre-orders for Xbox One version of Black Desert Online will be opened come January 7th in the Microsoft Store. The game doesn't have a solid release date yet, but the publisher has declared that it will be the first major MMORPG release of 2019. An open meta was held for the Xbox One last month, but we still don't know a lot about the game's implementing or impending launch on the platform. Hopefully, we'll hear more as the new year. And we have here episode 2 of Overkill's The Walking Dead arrives. Well, a new trailer has been released for Overkill's The Walking Dead, giving players a peek at the one or under one episode. The trailer showcases a new gas station location with several strategic entry points. Players will need the right tools though to get in. You'll find under one live right now, and when you are fired, the game up. 7 more episodes remain for the game's second season, with the remaining episodes rolling out one by one until June 2019. The game has sold poorly since launch, so hopefully the second season brings in more players for the game. And so, let's now head into Jump Force character creator showcased in the new trailer. Well, Bandai Namco has released a new trailer for Jump Force that reveals several details for the upcoming mashup fighter. Players will be able to create custom characters that they can use to fight alongside their favorite heroes. There's a ton of customization options available, and players will also be able to choose which special moves their characters can use. It's also been revealed that the game's antagonists are using the Onyx a book to reshape worlds, which could be the reason heroes from different worlds have come together to stop them. And we've got here Trunks, Renji, and Zabiro joining Jump Force. Bandai Namco has released screenshots for 3 new characters joining the Jump Force roster. These are the time-traveling Saiyan Trunks from Dragon Ball, Snake Princess Bo from One Piece, and 6th Division Lieutenant Renji from Bleach. Trunks will be sporting his Android Saga getup, while Bo will be donning her attire from the White Beard War Arc. Renki, Renji will be in his usual Shinigami robe. Jump Force is set to launch on February 15th for PC, Xbox One, and PS4. And And so now we've got here World of Warships celebrates the holidays with new content. Well, War of Warships will be bringing some holiday-themed content, starting off with the Name of His Highness event, which thrusts players into a series of challenges and missions that ultimately unlocks a new German premium tier 7 or 6 battleship called the Prince Ethel or Eitel Friedrich. Players will also get 2 free Santa Claus containers for logging in and heading to their ports. The update will also bring a new unlockable campaign called Mighty Prince and a premium campaign called Steel Monsters. And now we are down to our last news for today, but definitely not the least. That's the deal of the day from Allkeyshop. So our featured deal of the day is Oxen Free, which currently has the best price of 84 cents in our price comparison on Steam. It retails at €4.99. Get this game today through our price comparison and save 96% in your purchase. So, and for more of our deals of the day, please type in exclamation mark deal stream chat. Save more and compare to the key prices only here at AllkeyShop.com. So that's the deal of the day, guys. If you want to grab the offer, simply type in exclamation mark deal stream chat. Save more again for the CDK prices, or if you're going to use our price comparison, you will be saving 96% off on your CDK purchase. And again, for the comparison of CDK prices, visit AllkeyShop.com to find your best games and best games and best prizes only for you.
Treyarch has released a new Black Ops 4 update, changing armor durability in Black Ops once more. They have reduced the number of armor plates a player can stack from 5 to 10 and have increased the repair process by a second. Now the most noteworthy change, however, is making all 3 levels identical in durability value. Now this ensures that level 3 armors will break at the same rate as the level 1. The patch also featured a buff to the Paladin Sniper Rifle and more. And also, guys, heading on, we have Insomniac has added a new Sam Raimi suit to Marvel Spider-Man after a few fans threatened to boycott the game because the suit was not present. Preceding the update, PlayStation tweeted, "Surprise, it's time to party like it's 2002, as certain suit is available now in hashtag Spider-Man PS4. Yes, that suit that disgruntled fans were definitely among the minority, and some will argue that their fuss was unwarranted, but thanks to their efforts, the suit has been added to the game.
Police vehicle is under duress. Location is Museum Mile. Over.
Now, Bandai Namco announced that players are to expect Soul Calibur 6 version 1.11 patch in January of 2019. The patch includes gameplay adjustments and network fixes for all platforms, and the gameplay adjustments cover aspects of the battle gameplay which sometimes saw attacks represent incorrect values or misses due to inconsistency with the visuals and more. Now, the network fixes feature the issue of being stuck on the character or stage selection screen, among other changes.
Yeah.
Up next, we have here Tencent Games release a new survival mode for the Ring of Elysium named From Dusk Till Dawn. Now, the new mode is refreshing as there is no rescue helicopter. A brand new body as well temperature system adds another degree of difficulty to the mode, requiring you to stay focused. Now, in the core game mode, players race to eliminate each other in order to earn a spot on the rescue helicopter. But in the new mode, anyone who survives until sunrise is a winner. Now, you may choose to befriend other players or eliminate them as what
you want. We must give everything we've got. Fight until death rests us. Finally, we gathered around the fire. The firelight reflected on each one of us. A moment of peace.
Now, new features coming to Halo Infinite announced. During a Mixer stream, 343 Industries announced new features that will be coming to Halo Infinite. One of these features is the highly anticipated four-player split screen mode. The team at 343 is currently testing this feature along with the new engine. Now, this also means that the game won't be releasing anytime soon, as the testing could push the release date until after 2019. The studio also announced during the stream that players who reach level 152 in Halo 5 Guardians will receive a special reward, and that's going to be in Halo Infinite.
First Blood.
Now, Quake Champions December update is now live. It brings a host of changes to the game. Loot boxes will no longer be used in the game. Instead, each character gets a linear progression of cosmetic rewards as well as some extras for players who pick up the game's season pass. Also included in the update is the return of the Capture the Flag mode as well as a new map. This update is huge, and so you're looking at quite a big download here, guys. The patch notes are available in Bethesda's website. You check this one right now. Now, heading on to a new update, Skybound Games has announced that the last two episodes of Telltale's The Walking Dead, the final season, will release exclusively on the Epic Games Store for new owners. Those who already purchased the game's full season on other platforms won't have to worry, though, as they'll get the last two episodes delivered to them on their platform of choice. Now, those who are yet to purchase the final season will have to do so on the Epic Store game right now. Now, guys, the long-awaited Episode 3 entitled Broken Toys launches on January 15 of 2019.
The first person who taught me about survival was Lee.
What'd he teach you?
How to say goodbye.
In a new update, guys, For Honor is having a limited time crossover event called For the Creed. This event runs from December 20th until January 10th, and players can play the 4v4 Assassin's Creed Templari Dominion mode. Now, players must capture zones and lure one of the two commanders, Ezio Auditore de Firenze or Cesare Borgia. Now, defeating either of them rewards players with 300 points. Players who reach 1,000 points and defeating the opposing team during the breaking period will emerge as the winner. So that's Assassin's Creed. We have here new update for you guys. Square Enix launched a special event for Just Cause 4 players called Stunt Squad. This event allows players to capture their greatest stunts in the game and upload them in the Just Cause 4
First
website.
Blood.
Square Enix will be selecting the best stunts from the global community for each round and will be uploaded in the Just Cause YouTube channel. Now the best ones will win premium exclusive Stunt Squad merch and will be immortalized in the Hall of Fame. Hall of Fame, guys. So check this one. Now also, we have Street Fighter V. It will not be offering a season pass. Capcom confirmed this through a tweet after news of Cage joining the game's roster. Fans have been wondering why he was added not as part of a season pass as what's usually done. The tweet says, Cage can only be purchased individually with fight money or real currency. We currently have no plans to offer a season pass for the 2019 DLC characters. It also asks fans to stay tuned as Capcom will provide more information on future updates. The Steam Winter Sale is here and it comes with amazing games all at discounted prices. The sale is available now until January 3rd of 2019. Big games like Assassin's Creed Odyssey, Far Cry 5, Dragon Quest XI, Echoes of an Elusive Age, Hitman 2, and so much more are available in the sale. To keep you coming back, Steam also has come some freebies for you with the Extremely Cozy Cottage of Surprises. Here, free digital Steam community items and DLCs are going to be available each day until January 3rd as well. Now, Allkeyshop deal of the day, guys, you want to know this feature right now is Oxen Free, which is currently has the best price of 84 cents in our price comparison. On Steam, it retails at €4.99. You can get this game today through one of our price comparison and save 96% on your purchase. And for more of our feature deals of the day, please type exclamation mark deal in the stream chat right now. You can save more, compare to CD key prices here only at Allkeyshop.com. So do visit this website right now.
First Blood.